In order to import sound into Storyboard Pro, first you need to create an audio track. And you can do this in three ways. You can either right-click anywhere under the thumbnails in the timeline view and select New Audio Track, or you can go to the top menu and go to Sound, New Audio Track, or you can bring up the Sound Toolbar by going to Windows, Toolbars, Sound, and from the Sound Toolbar, you can click on the Create New Audio Track button. An audio track appears in the timeline view under the thumbnails, which is the first step that you need to import sound. So in order to import sound, you can right-click anywhere in the audio field and select Import Sound Clips, or you can go to the top menu and select File, Import, Sound Files, or after clicking anywhere on the audio track in the timeline view, you can go to the Sound Toolbar and select Import Sound Files. The Import Sound Clip dialog box appears, and you can click on this folder here to open the browser window to look for a sound file somewhere on your computer. So I'm going to select this WAV file right here and click Open. Next, from the target soundtrack area, you can decide if you want to create a new soundtrack or add this file to the current soundtrack, which is what I'd like to do. So I don't want to create another soundtrack here, I just want to add the sound file into the soundtrack. This enables the import rule, which allows you to either overwrite existing sound clips, were there sound clips in this audio track, or fill the next available frames. So if there was another sound file right here, this file would be imported just after. So I'm going to select Fill Next Available Frames, even though that's unnecessary in this case. Then in the Target Frame section, you can decide if you want to import this sound clip on the first frame, which would take us back to the start of the project, or to the current frame, which is what I'm going to select. And the current frame is determined by where the playhead is in the timeline. And then you can also check the Set as Default and Don't Show Dialog Again option if you want to keep all of these properties every time you import a sound file. And I'm going to leave that unchecked and then click OK. And as you can see, my WAV file has been imported into this audio track, into the location that I requested.